Hello, Puzzles and Pieces. It's Jessica from Multiplicity and Me, a channel dedicated to ending the stigma of dissociative identity disorder.
Oh, Ed's still so close and I'm still like so hungover.
The topic that was voted for by our patrons was how many alters have we had? But then we figured the best thing to do was broadening that to cover more of how many alters can someone have in general. We're going to break this down into three parts: research, wider reports, and then personal experience. So the first thing is, what does the research say? Well, it doesn't. As with many experiences of DID, there hasn't been enough research for a concrete answer in scientific journals. However, if we focus on the wider reports and the DSM-5 definition, it states that DID is a disruption of identity characterized by two or more distinct personality states. It means that at the very least, there needs to be two alters. So that could be myself plus another alter. So myself plus Jamie, myself plus Jake, Jake and Jamie, whatever, just two. I even sent a message to my specialist just to kind of ask if there was kind of any concrete evidence that he was aware of, and this is the text I received. So again, I don't think there is anything that's specifically stated in scientific journals, so I guess the best I can give you guys is kind of from personal experiences and the wider community. On the other hand, we have the incredible Jenny Haynes that made history recently by sending her abuser to prison, by giving evidence from her 2,500 alters. She is an amazing, incredible woman that has suffered an extreme amount of abuse. And yet she was so determined to do something about what happened to her, she got herself a PhD in law and then took her abuser to court. She has our uttermost respect for her ambition and bravery. And of course, if you wanted to check out her documentary, we will list it in the description below. Please check it out. She is a phenomenal, phenomenal woman. And again, just a case to show that you can have as little as five like us, or two less than us, right the way up to over 2,500 personalities. I mean, like I said, we have five, so any more than that kind of really blows our mind. And finally, what can I tell you about our experiences? Well, at some point we know that we had over 20 alters, but can we remember anything about them? Barely. We figure they were more fragments than alters, which are basically smaller parts of an alter. So obviously we're all parts of one whole, and the fragments kind of are like a smaller piece of that pie. So they may be more specific to a job role, they may have like kind of a 2D personality, they may not know what they kind of like and dislike, they may be quite focused, they may just have an emotional response, or they may carry a memory. They kind of are less of a 3D person than the guys that you see in my system today. But of course, just because fragments are kind of a smaller piece of that overall pie, that doesn't make them any less valued or less valid. Imagine water droplets on a window pane running together to be a bigger droplet. It might slide down the glass, meet another droplet, and get bigger and bigger and bigger as it slides down the pane. That's essentially what happens when alters fuse together. So when these water drops and stuff will kind of roll into one, they take those memories with them. So the new part has kind of the memories that go alongside with the other part and the other part, you know? So that makes sense. Am I making sense? They aren't a new part and no part is gone, but they are a more well-rounded part of the overall self. So as my guys are extremely kind of three-dimensional in the way that they are and the way that I am, we kind of feel that this is a sensible theory as to where all these 20 alters went. We feel that everyone's kind of slowly ran down that window pane and merged into the five of us you see today. Another theory could be that these parts are dormant. So there's just no way to know for sure. So dormant parts can lie dormant for years and years and years and years, and you may not know whether they have integrated into these water droplets or if they haven't. But we do remember some prominent alters, and I think the most prominent ones that we remember are Jenny. So Jenny was Jamie and Jake's sister. We feel that she and I kind of merged together. To put it frankly, I was a constant over-emotional, unstable mess. And she was confident and content, like, I guess a lot like Jamie, but with the enthusiasm and positivity of Jake. So mix that with the over-emotional mess that was me, and you get me today. I guess I'm still a little bit of an emotional mess, but not on the scale that I was years ago. So we think that's a sensible theory as to where Jenny went. We think that actually Jenny merged into me. I don't remember, there was nothing that happened. It's just that we think that's a sensible theory. We don't think she's around anymore. We don't think she's dormant, so she must have merged. Let's compare and contrast you know, what we were like previously versus after we feel that she went. And you can kind of see where her personality has kind of split off and gone into different parts, maybe, or parts of me. So it's a kind of a puzzle game, I guess. So another part that I had was a part called James, and he was the host for 6 years of my life. So from 6 to 12, he kind of owned my life. He was the main part that was out. He was extremely insecure, but in kind of a controlling and possessive way, so not the best kind of way to project that insecurity. And he was a straight guy, but other than that, I don't know much about him. I don't remember much about him. Jake was the alter that knew him the most, although the feedback we got from Jake is that he's one of those people that kind of just isn't a great person. Now, we don't know exactly what happened to James. We don't know if he kind of merged and spread pieces of himself into the other guys, or perhaps, again, if we're kind of splitting James into parts, kind of that insecurity and possessiveness piece went over to Ed, because James disappeared when we were about 13, and that was kind of the time that Ed came about. So it's kind of like, did he maybe take that? And then Ed kind of still has those grievances, you know, he still has kind of that possessiveness, a little bit jealousy and insecurity, but his delivery and how he projects that is much more healthy. And again, that's kind of all part of recovery. But that's our newest theory. I don't know how Ed feels about that, but it's just, you know, to him, Ed is just Ed. He doesn't really think about, you know, parts coming into him or, you know, changing in any way. So this is currently being explored by our specialist at the moment. So he's currently untapping those lost 6 years with Jake, because Jake grew up kind of alongside him as an alter part. So he has the most memories of James, I guess, out of all of us. And even though, like, Jamie was around too, Jamie really came out. He wasn't interested in this life, you know. So he has very few memories of that period of time. I think Jamie came out when we were about 9 years old. So, he doesn't really remember having all that much contact with the host alter at the time. So that's why we're kind of relying on Jake. So Jess, if you don't have any memories that those previous parts held, does that still mean they could all still be dormant? Yes. Which, I'm not gonna lie, frightened me to death when my specialist told me. However, another theory of his is that because our natural recall has always been so poor anyway, and that's kind of a consistent thing throughout our system, it doesn't matter who's fronting, all our memories past are really kind of rubbish. Like, we can't, everything is from a camera's perspective, our memories aren't the most reliable, so it's really, really difficult to kind of, yeah. Even amongst our friends we've made in the DID community, they know that our recall is very poor. That our brain simply learned to kind of reroute and lose these memories constantly growing up. As this disorder is also developmental, it would permanently have scarred and kind of rerouted the memory processing, which would explain our current predicaments. So there you have it. You can have as little as 2 parts of the self, or more than 2,500. But for us personally, we kind of separate our system. So we class our more whole selves as alters, the 5 of us, and therefore when people ask how many alters do you have, we say 5. But we know that we have had and still have fragments in the background. So little Jake, for example, we know to be a trauma holder. And we also have 2 pieces we think that splintered from Ed that are really deep down in the depths. We don't know if those parts, Eli and Eddie, are still around or if they're dormant, don't know. We may not know for a very long time either, and that's okay. We don't have to know right here and right now. I mean, it can be very hard to stick an exact number on how many people are in your system, which is kind of why we just stick to saying we have 5 and those are our main 5. And it's okay to not know exactly how many in your system there are. If you're a DID system, just remember that no matter your number, whether you know it's exact and concrete or you have no idea, you are still very much valid, and don't let anyone tell you otherwise. Okay, I think that's everything. I think we've covered everything. Good job, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you really enjoyed the segment, please don't forget to like, share, comment, subscribe. We also have Instagram, where we do upload exclusive stories and go live exclusively to that platform. So check it out if you want to keep up with us like more regularly from our stories. And we also have Facebook, Twitter, and we have Patreon if you want to support us with upcoming projects in the future. Every little really does help, and we're hoping to do even cooler projects than the 360 one that we did not so long ago. But yeah, Thank you so much for watching, everyone, and have a great day.